Hi students, yeah, today we are going to discuss the topic from real numbers, which is revisiting rational numbers part 2. Already in the last session we discussed how to prove that a given, you know, like root 2 as irrational, and I made you to do root 3 as irrational. Okay, so we discussed so far those kind of sums. Today we are going to discuss little same kind of sums in a, you know, like one more time, like one more example I'm going to discuss with you, and one or two examples we will take. Yeah, first one, prove that root 5 is irrational. Okay, see, the same kind of proof we are going to do what we did for the last sum. We proved that root 2 as irrational. So how do we prove? In the same way, we are going to prove that today also. Okay. First, what is the first step you have to consider? Let us assume to the contrary. Let us assume to the contrary that root 5 is rational. Okay, we will assume that root 5 as a rational number. So as I told you that we have to assume in the other way, contrary, in the sense we are going against the statement. The statement is root 5 is irrational, so we are assuming that opposite to the statement, which is root 5 is rational. Okay, so if any rational number, as we know that any rational number can be written in the form of p by q. So let root 5 is equal to a divided by b, where a and b are co-prime. Co-prime numbers are co-prime, and also b should not be equal to 0. Why b should not be equal to 0? If b is equal to 0, a by b will become infinity, not defined. So b should not be equal to 0. What we assume? We assume root 5 is equal to a by b, and a and b are co-prime. It means, what do you mean by co-prime numbers? We discussed before also, co-prime numbers are nothing but prime numbers which have the common factor 1 and itself. Okay, it does not have any factors other than 1 and itself. So we are assuming a and b are co-prime numbers. So next step, square on both the sides. So square on both sides. When you square, so what happens? Root 5 whole square is equal to a by b whole square. Correct? So a square by b square is equal to root 5. Root and square root and square will get cancelled. You will get 5 is equal to, a square by b square. So this can also be written as 5b square is equal to a square, and b square is equal to a square by 5. Okay, I hope you understood still this. Okay, so written b square is equal to a square by 5. And as we discussed from one theorem last class, we discussed a theorem that if a square, what is the theorem we discussed? If a square are written like this, p divides a square, then p divides a also. Correct? We discussed the theorem like this. If p divides a square, then p divides a also. Here, if b divides, we can write it as 5 divides, so we are writing in actual as 5 divides a, then we can also write 5 divides a square, then we can also write 5 divides a. See, a square is divisible by 5, correct? A square by 5 means what? A square is getting divided by 5, or 5 divides a square. If 5 divides a square, we can write 5 divides a also. Correct? That is the theorem we discussed in the last class. What is that? If p divides a square, then p divides a also. That is the last theorem we discussed. Here also, the same concept you are going to use. What is that? 5 divides a square, then 5 divides a. Correct? So now, one more assumption we will do. That is, assume a is equal to 5c. How can you assume a is equal to 5c? Can we assume a is equal to 5c? Because 5 divides a in the sense what? This a should be multiple of 5. For example, okay, if 5 is dividing a in the sense, it should be a multiple of 5, correct? Otherwise, it cannot divide any number just like that, correct? If a is getting divided by 5, means, or a square is getting divided by 5, means a should be a multiple of 5, correct? So, we can write a is equal to 5 into some number. It means it may be a multiple of 5. So, that's the reason I am taking a is equal to 5c. If you are not able to prove that 5 divides a, you cannot write a is equal to 5. Remember, a will be equal to 5c when this satisfies. Understood? If this doesn't satisfy, we cannot write a is equal to 5c. Why we are writing a is equal to 5c? Because a is getting divided by 5. Correct? So, if a is getting divided by 5, then definitely it should be a multiple of 5 also. For example, if 25 is there, 25 is getting divided by 5, it means 25 we can divide with 5, so 5 is a 25. So 25 is also multiple of 5, because 5 into 5 is 25. So any number which is divided by one number, that number should be multiple of that number. That is basic thing you have to understand. Example, at given, I am just writing and explaining it, 25 is there, right? So 25 is divisible by 5, because 5 is a 24. Okay, and 25 also written as 5 into 5. Okay, this can be written as 5 into 5, therefore it is divisible by 5. Understood? If any number is divisible by 5, that should be multiple of 5 also. This is the very basic thing which you have to know. That is the reason here I written 5 divides a, that's the reason I am assuming a is equal to 5c. Okay, so what we do, just you consider this as equation 1. So, substitute a is equal to 5c in equation, or you can write in 1, it means in equation 1. So, what I write, 5c whole square, because in the place of 5b square is equal to, in the place of a, I am writing 5c. So, 5c whole square. So what do you get? Just continue here. 5b square is equal to 5c whole square. It means this square belongs to both the terms. So, can I write this as 5 square c square? Correct? 5 square into c square. So, 5b square is can be written as 25c square. Correct? So, now, you can divide 5 with 5. So, what do you get? B square is equal to 5c square. So, this can also be written as 5, like b square by 5 is equal to c square. So, similarly, see there, b square is equal to a square by 5. What we written? 5 divides a square. Here, can we write 5 divides b square? Same step I am following. Okay? There, we return because a square by 5 is there. So, we are writing 5 divides a square. Correct? 5 divides a square. Similarly, here b square by 5 is there. That's the reason I am writing 5 divides b square. If 5 divides b square, then 5 divides b also. Correct? Understood? If 5 divides a square, how you return 5 divides a? Similarly, 5 divides b square, 5 divides b also. From these two statements, like two proofs, 5 divides a and 5 divides b, correct? 5 divides a also and 5 divides b also. It means 5 is the common factor. 5 is the common factor of a and b, correct? 5 is the common factor of a and b. It means what you can understand here, or what you come to know from this, because we assumed A and B are co-prime numbers. What are co-prime numbers? The numbers which do not have any other factors other than 1 and itself. But 5 is the common factor for A as well as B. So whatever we assume that is not correct. So okay, our assumption is wrong, correct? Our assumption is incorrect, or we can also say it as wrong. So our assumption is wrong, and root 5 is irrational. So root 5 is considered as irrational number. Okay? Understood? Yeah. This is how we have to prove. Yeah. Anyway, I'll explain once again. This proof is, anyway, this kind of sums we already discussed. So this is, anyway, as I told you, it is important for your examination point of view. So let me explain once again. What we have to prove that root 5 is irrational. So this is the sum we have to prove. So for that, what I am assuming, I am just assuming the contrary. Contrary in the sense, assuming opposite to the statement. For example, as I told you, Rama is a good boy. So we are assuming Rama is a bad boy, and we are able to prove that Rama is a bad boy. Hence, Rama is a good boy. So Rama is a good boy, right? So similarly, we are assuming that to the contrary. Contrary, clearly, if you don't write this contrary, no, then definitely your assumption is not correct. You have to write this keyword. This is called keyword. This keyword should be written. Okay? You have to write. Each steps are very important. Each and every step you have to specify. Let us assume to the contrary that root 5 is rational. So irrational is the, you have to prove it as irrational. But on contrary means we are assuming opposite to the statement, which is rational. So we are assuming that root 5 is, on the contrary, that root 5 is rational. If, and after that, we assume root 5 is equal to A by B. So, and where A and B are co-prime numbers. What are the prime numbers? Co-prime numbers are nothing but prime numbers. What are prime numbers? A number which does not have, you know, any common factors or any factors other than 1 and itself. So, A and B are like that, we are assuming. Okay? And also, we square on both of them. So, when you square, root 5 square will become 5, because square and root will get cancelled. A by B whole square, which is A square by B square, then cross multiply. So, which will become 5B square is equal to A square. And we can also write it as B square is equal to A square by 5. And this you take it as equation 1. Okay? And next, if, we are just recapping, we are just, once again, I'm just writing the statement of the last theorem, what we discussed in the last session, what it is, if P divides A square, then P divides A also, okay? If P divides A square, then P divides A. Similarly, if 5 divides A square, then 5 divides A also, correct? So just I'm using this statement. I don't want to explain this once again, because in the last video, I explained that clearly to you. Okay, 5 divides A square, then 5 divides A also. Okay, and here 5 divides A in the sense, it means A is getting divided by 5. If any number which is divisible by that number should be a multiple of that number also. Okay, if a number is divisible by, for example, if 25 is divisible by 5, correct. So that 25 should be a multiple. It means can we write 25 as 5 into 5? Correct. So similarly, 5 divides 25. And this, let us assume that A is 25. Correct. Let us assume that A is 25. So 5 divides 25. Definitely 5 divides is 5 also. Correct. Similarly, if 5 divides 25, and that 25, whatever the number which is getting divided, that divided by 5, that number should be multiple of the 5 also. That is the reason if 5 divides A, A should be multiple of 5. So A can be written as 5 into C. C may be any real number. Correct. Any number you can take for C. If any number multiplied by 5, definitely it is divisible by 5. So that is the reason A I can assume as 5 into C. Don't get confused with this you might get a doubt why I assume A is equal to 5C. The reason is we proved that this A is multiple of 5. That is the reason I'm writing A as multiple of, you know, 5. And let's see maybe any number, real number. Okay, this no need to specify. Okay, I'm just specifying for your understanding. Okay, so substitute A as 5 into C. Got it? When you substitute A as 5 into C in the equation 1, just I substitute in the equation 1. So 5b square, correct? The equation 5b square, in the place of A, I written 5c, 5c whole square. So 5b square is equal to, this square belongs to both the terms which are there inside the, as a base we have 5c, right? So 5 square, c square, correct? So 5b square is equal to 5 square is 25, c square we retain as it is. So 5 1s are, 5 5s are. So we got b square is equal to 5 c square. This can also be written as b square by 5 is equal to c square. And similarly, there you observe b square is written as a square by 5. So what do you written in the next step? 5 divides a square. Similarly, here can I write it as 5 divides b square? There you written, because b square is equal to a square by 5, that's why I written 5 divides a square. Here, b square by 5 is equal to c square, means b square is getting divided by 5. So that's the reason, 5 divides b square and write. 5 is dividing b square. If 5 divides c square, according to the theorem what we discussed in the last class, which will become 5 divides b, correct? That is only I explain now. So, and what we have, like we got, or what we understood from this explanation or for this, from this calculation part or simplification part or the proof part, whatever it is. So 5 is a common factor for both A and B also. Okay, 5 is a factor for both A as well as B. It means what we assumed A and B as, we assumed A and B as prime numbers or co-prime numbers, means which should have a common factor, which do not have a common factor, and they should have only two factors, which is 1 and 5. But we are getting one more factor, which is 5. So our assumption is incorrect or wrong. We assumed wrong. We assumed that root 5 is rational, but we are not able to prove that root 5 is rational because A and B has, okay? A and B, we are getting A and B are as, not as a co-prime number. We are getting as a composite number. It means which have more than one factor. So hence, correct. Whatever we assume, root 5 is rational, but we are not able to prove that root 5 is rational, then what it will be? Definitely it is irrational. So hence, we can prove that root 5 is irrational number. Okay, I hope you understood. Just let me go with the next sum. Okay, it is not a same kind of sum. But compared to this sum, this, whatever this, prove that, next term what we are discussing is prove that 5 minus root 3 is irrational will be easier than this. Okay, so much proof will not be there for you. Okay, yeah. Let me do that. Okay, I will start from here. Prove that 5 minus root 3 is irrational number. Okay, so first step, same thing we have to assume. Okay, we have to assume to the contrary that, okay, the given number is rational. Let us assume to the contrary that 5 minus root 3 is rational. Okay, we are assuming on the contrary basis. Correct. So same thing what we assumed for the last one. Let us assume to the contrary that 5 minus root 3 is irrational. Sorry, rational. So now, what is the next step? We should assume it as, again, 5 minus root 3 is equal to a by b, where a and b are co-prime. Where a and b are co-prime. And also, b should not be equal to 0. That is the assumption I have to make. 5 minus root 3 is equal to a, b, a by b, and a and b are co-prime, correct? And what is the next step? You just like send this root 3 to the other side. So 5 minus AB is equal to root 3. What I'm doing, I'm just sending this minus root 3 to the HS, and plus A by B to the LHS. So plus A by B will become plus minus A by B when it comes to the LHS, and minus root 3 will become plus root 3 when I send to the RHS. So we got 5 minus A by B is equal to root 3. So take LCM. LCM for 1 and B is B, correct? LCM for 1 and B is B. Just cross multiply. 5 into B minus 1 into A, which is equal to root 3. So 5B minus A by B is equal to root 3. Okay, and here we assumed A and B as, you know, like integers. Or see, remember, even this coprime numbers are also integers. 1, 2, 3, any number. See, what are the prime numbers? We have 2, 3, correct? 5, 7, 11. These are also integers. First they are integers, then only they are prime numbers, correct? So here, where, we can also say that B, A are integers, correct? Here, B and A are integers, correct? If B and A are integers, can we assume this as a, you know, like rational number? Obviously, if A and B are integers, then this 5 minus AB or 5B minus A by B is rational number, because a number which can be written in P by Q form, definitely that is considered as a rational number. This is the form of P by Q. Okay. So, but in the last cases, in the last form also, root 5 what we proved? Root 5 we proved it as irrational number. Root 2 we proved as irrational number. And root 3 which I ask you to do it. And root 3 also we proved as irrational number. The fact is root 3 is an irrational number, but we are getting root 3 as rational number. So this contradicts the fact root 3 is, before that let me write one more here. Okay. Here, or we can write like this. So we are getting root 3 as, we get root 3 as rational number. Okay, because 5b minus a is a minus a by b is in the form of p by q. So definitely root 3 is a rational number. But this contradicts the fact that root 3 is irrational, correct? This is a fact B. How the fact that root 3 is irrational, but it contradicts. Contradicts means we are getting the proof in the other way. Okay, so we are getting root 3 as rational. So 5 minus root 3 is irrational, correct? Understood? So definitely we assume 5 minus root 3 as 5 minus root 3 is equal to a by b, and we are able to prove that root 3 is equal to 5b minus a by b, and that we are able to prove that as rational number. But actually the fact is root 3 can never be a rational number. It is an irrational number. Root 3 is an irrational number. But whatever the assumption, whatever the proof we got, it contradicts the fact. So obviously when it contradicts the fact, so the given number what we have taken is irrational number. Correct? So that is the reason it is irrational number. So you can ask me, sir, 5 minus root 3, how it might be irrational? I will give an example, or I will just prove that and let you know. 5 minus root 3. Right? Remember, root 3 value is 1.732 and so on. Actually, this is a rational number. You will never get a terminating decimal. Approximately, you take the value of root 3 as 1.732. That is there. It is the fact we, you might have studied. If you don't know, you just see the 8th standard, not in 8th, 7th or 6th, root 3 values also, they will find. Root 3 value is 1.73. Okay. And when you subtract, this is a terminating decimal. Non-terminating decimal.
2 in the 5, if you subtract 1.72 and dot dot, you will get 4.732 dot dot. It means 4.732, it might be, it will never stop, division. So, as we know that in 9th standard you might have studied, a number which is non-terminating and non-repeating is considered as an irrational number. So the number what we got, which is 4.732 dot dot, it means it is not repeating. See, any number is repeating over there? No. No number is repeating. Correct? And it is not even getting terminated. See, stop. Decimal expansion is not getting stopped and it is a non-repeating decimal. So this kind of decimal expansion we consider as irrational number. So definitely 5 minus 2 is irrational number. This is only for your understanding, I proved. It is not required. So here only you can confirm, if once you get root 3 as irrational, or root 3 is, once you get root 3 as rational, it is contradicting the fact root 3 is irrational. So there itself you can prove that 5 minus root 3 as an irrational number. Okay? Yeah, let me explain once again. See, this sum is not like a the sum which we did, you know, like in the last sum and the last before sum. It's a little different from that. So basically, remember, root 3, we have a value. Okay, root 3 value is 1.732 dot dot dot. So 1.732 we will take for calculation purposes. But exactly, root 3 value cannot be written. For example, how, why I am telling that, 1 by 2 we can write 0.5. Root 3 is 1.732 dot dot. It means that value or that decimal expansion will never end. Exact value of root 3 is not there. So whatever the value you take, that is an approximate value. So when you do 5 minus root 3, you are getting 4.732 dot dot. It means which is again irrational. Remember, any irrational number added to the rational number. See, 5 is a rational number. So root 3 is an irrational number. So we subtracting a rational number from irrational number, still you will get an irrational number. If you multiply a rational number with an irrational number, you will get a rational number. Oh, sorry, you will get an irrational number. Any number multiplied, added or divided with irrational number will be again an irrational number. So very rare cases are with the same number if you multiply. For example, root 3 multiplied with root 3, you will get root 9. That is the rational. Very rare cases. I am not telling you will not get rational at all. You will get something. Anyway, in this depth, you know, in depth, I don't want to go with that. Yeah. So basically what I am telling, 5 minus root 3 is an irrational number. That is already we know. If you just solve it and check, solve and check for your, you know, like understanding purpose, definitely you will get an irrational number. But we have to prove it. So that's the reason. First what I did, let us assume to the contrary that 5 minus root 3 is an rational number. So we are assuming in the contrary. Contrary in the sense what? Opposite to the statement. So we assume 5 minus root 3 as A by B. So what is A and B, where A and B are two like co-prime numbers. What are the co-prime numbers? A number which have, you know, like a common factor, which does not have a common factor and which has a factor 1 and its own. Okay, that are called co-prime numbers. So what I did, in this I put an arrow mark for understanding. This A minus B I sent to the LHS, which became minus A by B, and the root 3 I sent to the RHS, which became plus root 3. So this can be written as C. A and B, B and 1 LCM is B, and cross multiply. 5B into B, 5B minus A into 1A. So 5B minus A by B is equal to 2, 3. So here, we assumed A and B are co-prime numbers. Even prime numbers, or natural numbers, or whole numbers, they are also comes under integers. So we got root, this 5b minus a by b is a rational number, because when you take any number, you are writing this label in the form of p by q. Correct? A number which can be written in the p by q form is a rational number. So here root 3 we are able to write in the p by q form. This denominator is q, and numerator if you consider p, this is in the form of p by q. So you are able to write root 3 in the form of p by q. That is the reason we got root 3 as a rational number. But we know that root 3 is not a rational number. Correct. Root 3 is an irrational number. We did prove first. Correct. We proved that root 3 as an irrational number. But we are getting root 3 as a rational number. So
it contradicts. This contradicts the fact that root 3 is irrational. So we are getting the proof against the fact. So definitely it cannot be an rational number. Correct? So that is the reason even we can say 5 minus root 3 is irrational. Okay? Yeah, that's the reason I explained you also. Definitely 5 minus root 3 will not be rational. Okay? So just you see the calculations. 5 minus 1.732, you will get 4.732 dot dot. Dot dot. Whenever you get a terminating decimal with, whenever you get a, sorry, non-terminating decimal with no digit repeated in the decimal expansion, it is an irrational number. So definitely, this 5 minus 3 is also an irrational number. So hence, we proved that as irrational number. Okay? So, I hope you understood this. And guys, one small request for you all guys, please share, comment, like and subscribe to our channel. Please support us. Thank you.